So basically, in today's lecture, we are going to study about the incremental, iterative, and the agile model, right? So these three models we are going to study, and on the basis of which we are going to analyze which type of project should we have for a specific model, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of these models. So taking the first one as the iterative model is taken up with the name, that is iteration. So as the name suggests, iteration means the loop. Working on certain steps again and again until a specific condition is reached, right? So this is called as the iteration. So on the similar fashion, this particular iterative model will work. Iterative process starts with a simple implementation of a subset of software requirements and iteratively enhances the evolving versions until the full system is implemented, right? That means in this, the project is taken up and simple implementations are done in a specific phase one, and then this is being enhanced iteratively until we have the final version evolved and the full system is implemented, right? At each iteration, design modifications are made and new functional capabilities are added. So in the first phase, the basic implementations are done, and in the next iterations, the basic implementations are enhanced by adding certain features. The basic idea behind this method is to develop a system through repeated cycles, that is the iteration, that is iterative, and in smaller portions at a time, that is incremental. So two things are working on, that is iterative and incremental. Iteration is the repeated cycles, and incremental means in small portions, the implementation is being done. This process may be described as an evolutionary acquisition or incremental build approach. So there's a little bit difference between the incremental approach we are going to use in the next model. So this is the graphical format or the graphical representation how the iterative model works. See, first we have the requirements. The first phase is the requirements. So we are going to figure out all the requirements. We are going to analyze the requirements and develop a SRS for the same. That is software requirement specification as the output of requirement analysis. On the basis of which we are going to build the project or build certain subset of projects in iterations. First of all, we will release the build one in which design and development is done, testing it is done, and then implementation is done. This is released. Then build two is defined. Design and development is done, testing is done, and implementation is done, and finally it is released, and so on and so forth. Now it will depend on the type of project and the size of project, how many iterations will it cover, right? Now, what are the advantages of iterative model? The results are obtained early and periodically. Why the results are obtained early? Results are obtained early because we are releasing the subset of project periodically, time to time. As we can see here, the build one is released. We are not going to wait till the second build is being designed and developed. Second build is released until build three is not started yet, right? So we are going to get the result periodically, and it is attained early. Parallel development can be planned. So we can see that if a particular simple functionalities are implemented and released, and there are certain functionalities which are complex to be implemented, we can parallelly do that, and till that particular has been resolved, we have still released a subset of the project to the customer. So customer will not panic. Progress can be measured easily. Less costly to change the scope requirement. We can always involve the change in the requirements as we are building in phases. Testing and debugging during smaller iteration is easier as compared to the final version. Risks are identified and resolved during iterations, and each iteration is easily managed with a milestone. It is easy to manage risk. We have already seen this. Why it is easy to manage risk? Because we are not waiting for the final product in one go. We are getting the product periodically and at the early stage. With every increment, operational product is delivered. Issue, challenges, and risks identified from each increment can be utilized, applied to the next increment. So these are certain advantages of iterative model. Next one is the disadvantages of iterative model. Now, when we say the disadvantages of iterative model, what we say, more resources may be required. When we are working parallelly on the project with certain subsets, we can require or we may require more of resources, right? That is a disadvantage. Although cost of change is lesser, but it is not very suitable for changing requirements. The changes in the requirements can be adapted and it can cost less. But if the changes are moderately, if the requirements are moderately changing, we can adapt it. But highly changing requirements cannot be adapted in this particular requirement because we have or we are implementing or we are releasing the subset or operational product time to time basis. More management attention is required. Management involvement is required. More to it. System architects or design issues may arise because not all requirements are gathered in the beginning of the entire life cycle. Now, in this, we all know that until and unless we get the SRS, we are unable to define a proper design. Right? So if the requirements are not defined or gathered at one go or with minimum changes, the design can be hampered. Defining increments may require a definition of complete system. That means we have to define the increments and that will require the definition of complete system. It is not suitable for smaller projects. Obviously, if you have a large project, a large scale project, only then you are suitable for the iterative model. End of project may not be known, which is a risk. Final product is unknown, and that can be termed to be as a risk. So, next one is incremental model. Now, what is incremental model? Incremental development is a development approach that slices the product into fully working slices that are increments. Each new increment builds on top of existing released functionality. Now, you must be thinking that this is like a little bit similar to the iterative model, but no. This is different from iterative model because in incremental development, what we are doing, we are releasing the product, releasing the subset of a product in operational form, but in smaller subsets. And we are releasing the functionalities. Let's make it more clear with the help of an example. Let's take an example. If we have a example of e-commerce site. A project is there of e-commerce site, and in this particular, we are choosing the iterative model. When the iterative model is choosing, let's say the team is building the e-commerce website using an iterative model. Then how it will do? E-commerce website. So in the iteration process, the first release has a really stripped back version of all the required functionalities, such as names, searching a product, product information, that is the product page, then the basket, that is the shopping basket, is available, and the payment processes defined. So in iterative process, all these functionalities will be included in build one. Let's say in build one, all these functionalities will be included. But in a very simple format. So this is the first version in which we are including the name, search of product, product information, shopping basket, let's say checkout, and the customer reviews. In the second iteration release, in the second build means, we will increase the functionalities of, we will increase the features of all the functionalities. Example, the team would improve some of the existing basic functionalities, taken into account of feedback from the stakeholders or from customers or any other inputs. And they can also provide the analytics, the statistics, the graph regarding the same. Then in the third build, they can enhance these particular functionalities with more features. Example, new ideas can be ranged. There can be different security provided to the payment mode. More secure versions are included in the payment mode. So basically you can say in iterative model, in first release, all the functionalities are included with the basic version. And in next iteration, the basic functionalities will enhance their features and go on and go forth in the next iterations. Now, taking the consideration of incremental model with the same site, that is, it is also working on the e-commerce website, and how it will do if they are using the incremental model. Now, this will say that in first release, in the incremental model, the first release, the team builds the basic functionality to buy a product. In it, it includes search, product, information, and adding products to a shopping basket. Right? And this is being done in the first slice of the release. So this is being done. The second release will include on the basic functionality and would add another capabilities, such as it will include the favorites. It will add favorites to it. It will add new option, that is customer review. Then in next release, third release, it can add the other versions, such as of different products are added to the form. So in this way, the iteration process is working in this form, while the incremental is working in this form. So this is the difference between the two. Next one is the Agile. Now, Agile is the latest approach or latest model, process model, which is being used. Agile model believes that every project needs to be handled differently. That means they are not considering every project in the same way. The existing methods need to be tailored to best suit the project requirements. We need to analyze which project requires or tailors which existing methods. In Agile, the tasks are divided into time boxes, that means small time frames, to deliver specific features for a release. Iterative approach is taken and working software is built, delivered after each iteration. Each build is incremental in terms of features. So basically here we are using both the iteration plus the increment model. The final build will hold all the features required by the customer. Now, this is the agile model. It is also working in iterations and in incremental form. So both the properties of iteration model and the incremental model are involved. And this is working in the same way. So next thing, the best part is the task is divided into small time boxes or small time frames, which is being defined as, let's say, this is the process. This is the graphical form of the agile model. This is the iteration one. The complete phases are taken care. Next, after 2-3 months, we have the next iteration of the same. And after 2-3 months, next iteration. So we are going to work in iteration and incremental model both. Now, agile model have 4 principles. What are these 4 principles? We will see. The 4 principles are, first is individuals and interaction. That means self-organization and motivation are important, as are interactions like co-location and pair programming. That means whenever and wherever and however it is needed, pair programming should be encouraged and co-location is done. Next, working software. Demo working software is considered the best means of communication with the customer to understand their requirements instead of just depending on documentation. See, customer is not always aware of all of his requirements. So you have to bring out or take out the requirements from the customer with the interactive sessions. We are going to study further that we can have different sessions with the customers like questionnaires, surveys, interviews to pull out the requirements which actually the customer cannot state in a proper form. So the demo working software is considered to be the best means of communication so that the customer can easily find out that what requirements are missing. Third point, we have the principle as customer collaboration. Rigorous interaction is being done between the customer and the developer or the team. As the requirements cannot be gathered completely in the beginning of the project due to various factors, it is not necessary that all the requirements can be analyzed and defined in the beginning only. So that is why continuous customer interaction is very important to get proper product requirements, right? And lastly, the response to change. IT is focused on quick responses on to change and continuous development. The changes can be adapted easily and continuous development is being forced. Now, this was the agile model, which is basically used in today's industry. Because why it is being used maximum? Because it is working on the change and continuous process, and it is able to adapt the maximum changing requirements of the customer, and it is having the quality of all the advantages of all the models which are in there. Now, what is the selection basis for the process model? So what is the basis? The basis is the parameters which we are going to be considering for selection of process model for any type of project is, we are going to study the characteristics of the customer, the characteristics of the requirement. That means whether the requirements are changing or frequently changing or not changing or stable or so on. Characteristics of projects to be developed. That means whether the project is a large scale, whether the project is of complex nature or of simple or of small scale and so many things. And lastly, the boundation of time, budget and quality. So according to these 4 parameters, we are going to decide which process model we need to select for our project. So that's all for this particular lecture. Thank you very much.